Talofa. My name is Pastor Ted Leiato with the Lighthouse Temple Church in Na'ua under the Voice of Christ for Gospel Church Ministry. We would like to welcome you again to another program, and we pray that this program will be a blessing to you. So our program will be in English so we can reach a wider audience. But before we start our program, I would like to address our Samoan people in our native tongue. Ia fata alofa tu le pa ia mani mamalu a tato atunu. Vi ia leli, vi ia Yesu. Fata ilona alofa mulonga na anga lele, le uto mawaile a mnoa, tato te mafuta ilunga le upenga te failangi. Ia fai ne po kalama fa mangiana, ilo fa fuma mai le ne Yesu. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Now it's time for us to share the word. So I'd like to share from the book of Genesis, chapter 42. I'm going to read verse 6 and verse 9. And it says, Joseph was the governor over the land, and he was that sold to all the people of the land. And Joseph's brothers came and bowed down themselves before him with their faces to the earth. And then it says in verse 9 that Joseph remembered the dreams which he dreamed of them. Now, I'd just like to bring that up about dreams. You know, a lot of us, God gives us a dream, puts it in our hearts, you know, and then we have challenges that rises up in our lives over the years, you know, and then try to extinguish that dream that God put in your heart, just like Joseph. As we can see, Joseph's dream came to pass. If you go to Genesis chapter 37, I'm going to read from verse 5. It says, Joseph dreamed a dream, and he told it to his brethren, and they hated him yet the more. Verse 7, this is his dream. He said, behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheaf arose and also stood upright. And behold, your sheaves stood round about and made obeisance to my sheaf, or they bowed down to my sheaf. And then verse 8 says, they hated him yet more for his dreams and for his words. And sometimes it's like that. Joseph was 17 years old. He probably told his dreams to his brother, you know. And anyways, that's why they hated him. They became very jealous of him. And then again, Genesis 37 verse 9, he had a second dream. He dreamed yet another dream and told his brethren and said, behold, I have dreamed a dream more, and behold, the sun and the moon and the stars, the 11 stars, they all bowed down before me, or bowed down to me. If you notice, God revealed the first dream to Joseph. It had to do with sheaves of grain. I guess that means, you know, Joseph probably has a future in the grain industry, or, you know, in the farming industry. LOL. And then God gave Joseph another dream about the sun, the moon, and the stars bowing down again before him. And again, you know, what's the star? What's the moon? What is the sun? And it's up in the heavens, or in heaven. Sun, the moon, and the stars. So that dream also meant, right, that this thing is straight from God. When you have two dreams and it's similar, that's confirmation. That means you have a second dream again, it means the same thing. And this also means that Joseph had a future, probably as a in royalty, governance, and also that is because it's in heaven, that means this is straight from God. It's already established in heaven, and no man, nobody can alter the plans of God for Joseph's life. And it says that when his father later on sent Joseph out to check on his brothers, they saw him from far away and they were like, oh, here comes that dreamer. Let's get rid of him once and for all. Let's slay him. And anyways, as we know, they threw Joseph in the pit. They wrongfully beat him. They wrongfully stripped him of his coat of many colors that his father's made for him. Because they were so, you know, their jealousy caused all this. And they threw him in the pit. And then later on, they sold him as a slave. And Joseph was wrongfully taken away from his father and his family. So much for Joseph's dreams, right? Wrong. It says that, you know, Joseph continued to trust in God. And you can see that through Joseph's life. You know, Joseph went through some really, really hard times, sold as a slave. He was done evil by his brothers. He didn't do anything wrong, just because they were, you know, jealous, and then they did evil to him. And yet Joseph still continued trusting God. Psalms 91 verse 4, it says, he shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings thou shalt trust. Under his wings shalt thou trust. Amen. In other words, you know, under God's wings, no matter what situation you're in, no matter the challenges that you're facing that's beating that dream out of you, trying to beat down that dream that God gave you, just continue to trust under His wings. And it says under His wing, Psalms 91 verse 4, under His wing shalt thou trust, or shalt thou take refuge, another translation. Just continue to take your refuge under God's wing. Continue to trust in God. And you know, Joseph, regardless of what happened to him, was very bad, was very evil what was done to him, but he continued trusting God. How do you know? You see it in his life. You see it in his actions. You see it in his speech. So if we go to Genesis verse 39, I'm going to start from verse 2. It says, the Lord was with Joseph. That's the number one factor in anything, in any situation in life. The Lord was with Joseph. Make sure the Lord is always with you. Don't run away from the Lord. Run to the Lord. Always go under His wings. Take refuge and trust under His wings. Praise the Lord. It says, the Lord was with Joseph, and he was prosperous. And he was a prosperous man. He was in the house of his master, the Egyptian, which is Potiphar. And it says, his master saw that the Lord was with him. This is a heathen. This is a non-believer. But he saw God was with Joseph. How do you know? How does he know that? How does he know he saw God with Joseph? It must have been in the way Joseph acted. It must have been the way that he talked. He must have seen Joseph praying to his God, you know, paying homage to his God. And then he saw, no matter what Joseph said to do, it prospered. And it says that his master saw, verse 3, chapter 39, the master saw that the Lord was with him and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. Now look into your hands. I don't care what situation you're in now. Look into your hands and say, God is with me. My hands are prosperous hands. Amen. God is with you. Your hands are prosperous hands because God is with you. Praise the Lord, because the Lord is with you. And it says, verse 4, Joseph found grace in his sight. He served him. You see that? It says, Joseph served him. Always have that heart of service. Always have that heart of a servant. Like Philippians 2, it says, Jesus did not thought it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation. It said that he poured himself out, took on the form of a servant. Why? And he was obedient even to the death on the cross. He said, I did not come for people to serve me. I came to serve them, to serve us. Amen? And you know, everybody thought after his resurrection, it stopped. No, it stopped there. Jesus is still serving us. The grace of God is still serving us as his people. Praise the Lord. And it says that Joseph found grace in his sight and he served him. And he made him overseer over his house. And all that he had, he put into his hands. And it says, it came to pass from the time that he had made him overseer in his house. Listen to this. And over all that he had, I want you to listen here. It says that the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. Okay, it says the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. Wherever you're working, you might not like your job, whatever you're doing now, you might, but as long as you continue to trust in God, continue to trust under His wing. In other words, continue to surrender to God. Allow God. You know, the biggest training ground for God, that where He trains us, where He shapes us and molds us, is life. This life here, this temporary life we're living, that's God's biggest training ground. No matter what comes our way, we need to continue to trust in God. Just like Joseph, he continued to live for God, and God prospered everything that he did. And it says the Lord, verse 5, the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. You know, your business or the company you work for, God blesses it for your sake. Amen. And it says, and the blessing of the Lord was upon all that he had in the house and in the field. Indoors, outdoors. Did you see that? God blessed everything this Egyptian had in his house and in the field. Who was working all these things in the house and in the field? It was Joseph. As a slave, God was training to it because Joseph continued to trust in God. God and allowed to surrender to him, allow God to move through him, even in dire negative circumstances, God turned it into a positive. God used that circumstance as a training ground for Joseph. He was trained in the house. He was trained in the field. Because what he did in the house prospered. What he did out in the field prospered. What's out in the field? Crops, grain. You see where this is going? Joseph was learning probably the basics, you know, on a smaller scale, the house of his master. He was learning about farming. He was learning about storing the grain. And then in the house, whatever he was doing in the house, administrative, he was learning all that. Okay? And then it says that verse 6, he left all that he had in Joseph's hand, and he knew not aught he had, save the bread which he did eat. And Joseph was a goodly person and well favored. That's all Potiphar, his master, cared about, was just what he ate. Everything he entrusted to Joseph. And God found favor with Joseph. Everything Joseph did prospered. What he did in the house, what he did in the field, prospered. And it was setting him up. It was training him. Life, you know, life happens. Good and bad. It happens to all of us. Circumstances, challenges come our way. We're going to face Goliaths. If we continue to trust under God's wing, he will use that to mold us, to shape us, to prepare us for something greater. Amen? So he continued to trust God as a slave. But then, as we all know, Joseph must have gotten comfortable. He probably thought, this is it. This is his life. No. But no, that wasn't God's plan. Unfortunately, Potiphar's wife bothered him day after day. Come lie with me. You know, come lie with me. It says day by day, she constantly bombarded Joseph. Come and lie with me. And Joseph told her, I can't do this wickedness, you know, and sin before God. See, Joseph's talk and his action, he was still trusting God. I think it was someone else that would have jumped at the opportunity. You know, when the master's away, oh, the wife, it's a pretty wife. But Joseph, he said, I'm not going to do this wickedness. And then it got so bad, she grabbed him. And then he, you know, he left his outer garment or whatever he was wearing and just ran away from her. You know, because he didn't want to sin. And then the lady lied, of course, Potiphar's wife lied. And then it said Joseph was thrown in prison. So, you know, Joseph was wrongfully beaten because of jealousy. He was wrongfully thrown in a pit. He was wrongfully sold as a slave, stolen away from his family, you know, as a 17-year-old. And here, when he begins to prosper, he's beginning to settle down, getting comfortable. And then his whole world turns upside down. Potiphar comes home. Here's what his wife has to say. He should have gotten the death penalty. I think maybe Potiphar knew something, because it says he threw him in prison. But even in prison, you know, Joseph got another demotion. He went even further down. And listen to this. Genesis 39, verse 21 and 23. It says, but the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy, and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. And the keeper of the prison committed to Joseph's hand all the prisoners that were in prison. And whatsoever they did there, he was the doer of it. Listen to this, verse 22. It says, the keeper of the prison, or the warden, committed to Joseph's hand all the prisoners that were in the prison. And whatever they did there, whatsoever they did there, the prisoners, it says, he, who's he? It was Joseph. He was the doer of it. And it says the keeper of the prison did not look at anything that was under his hand, because the Lord was with Joseph, with him. And that which he did, the Lord made it to prosper. Even in the worst of places, in prison, God caused Joseph to prosper. And everything that the prisoners, all the prisoners were under Joseph, and anything that they did, he was the doer of it. What do prisoners do? They do hard manual labor, right? And Joseph, from there, he started learning management skills. You know, what I'm saying is, all these things, negative things that happened in Joseph's life, that butted against his dream, this dream that God gave him as when he was 17 years old. All these things, the negative things that God was training him, preparing him. And you can tell Joseph continued to trust in his God, even in spite of all the bad things that happened to him, because of a lie, because of jealousy, because of wickedness. He was wrongfully, a lot of evil things was done to him wrongfully. And yet he continued to trust in God. And you know what? You can't keep a good man down. You cannot, once God puts a dream in you and you continue to trust it, it will come to pass. Nobody can stop it. So I would like to continue our sharing about the story of Joseph. There's a lot of hidden jewels in this story I would like to share with you, but I am running out of time, and I hope you will join us again next week as we continue the story about Joseph, as we continue to share about Joseph the dream. Amen. So hold on to that dream that God gave you. Don't let go. Continue to trust in Him, and He will see you through. May God bless you. I hope you enjoy this our sharing today of the Word, and I pray that the Word will come alive in your heart. So God bless you. I'm going to end our program today with a prayer. And I would like to pray for you, our audience. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you, Lord, for your mercy, for your grace. We thank you, Lord, for this golden opportunity that we have to come on the internet, YouTube, or through whatever social media stream, to be able to share the word. Thank you for technology, Lord. Father God, thank you for giving mankind, the ability to come up with all these different technologies. And I thank you, Lord, because of your love and grace, you didn't make us after the image of anything else. You made us after your own image, after your own likeness. Even though we're made from the earth, from dust, and to dust we will return. But you made us in your image after your likeness, because that's grace, Lord. We pray, Father God, that you bless your people, especially those that are in deep need right now, Father God. And just like Joseph, no matter what circumstances came his way, he continued to trust in you. We pray, Father God, you'll bless your people listening right now. Anybody that needs healing, anybody that needs help, Father God, in any area of their life, thank you, Lord. You are our deliverer. Thank you, Lord. You are our healer. Thank you, Lord. You are our Abba, Father, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. Lord Jesus, you said, ask and it shall be given. We ask, Father God, that you will meet all the needs of your people according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Bless all those that were able to join our program today, Father, and we pray for your mercy and your grace to continue over their lives, Lord, in Jesus' name. And may we continue to grow in your grace and in our knowledge of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name we pray, Father God. We give you back all the praise, honor, and glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen and amen. See the light in the sea of my face.